Well, put on your Wellington boots and join me. We are going to meet the harvest mouse in a marshland. Vast marshlands with tall dense vegetation and willow shrub are preferred by the harvest mouse. In winter or early spring, the best you can hope for is to find a breeding nest. In September, there's a good chance that you will find the typical nests and live animals as well. This is a typical breeding nest, intricately woven and about the size of a tennis ball. After the breeding, the nest looks really battered. It cannot be used again. Sometimes a frog will occupy an abandoned nest. A harvest mouse sneaks out of the nest and disappears quickly into the vegetation. Climbing in the stalk zone of the vegetation is a second nature to the harvest mouse. They certainly don't like to take a dip in the pool. Although they can swim, they tend to avoid it. It's a very agile animal, carefully testing the strength of stems and leaves. The harvest mouse is rather unique in having a prehensile tail and can take a very firm and precise grip on any available support. It's not always easy to get a harvest mouse in front of your camera. The outer toe of the hind foot is opposable, enabling the mouse to take a firm grasp of stems. These are fledglings, exploring the surroundings. The mouse on the right side took a dip in the pool. The fur is a little bit wet. When you take a careful look, you can see the water down below. The water here is rather deep, one step beyond and my boots will be soaked. The world, as seen through the eyes of a harvest mouse. The harvest mouse is the most attractive and interesting animal. Sometimes they are called red rennies. They are my all-time favorite.